am at Exhibit 320 with a very interesting personality. The problem is that Princess P cannot speak. So I have had to actually ask her alter ego to speak today. And, you know, tell us a little bit about the work she's put up in this show and what's happening, because some, I think they're a great critique on contemporary society, besides actually being a lot of fun as well. And the whole thing about having, existing in so many different worlds parallel and existing together. So Princess P's alter ego. Can you tell us a little bit about what's happening with the works?
Well, the works here are basically do with my, inner desire, which was from long ago about, to pose in front of the camera, and I could not do it. So the whole idea is to, pose and then have my alter ego, which is Princess P, pose for me, and we talk about the perfection of, the idea of beauty and perfection and the notion of perfection we have in our minds. So she's trying to, show the very traditional side, like, the Shalbhanjikas are from the traditional Indian old style of posing, and today Shalbhanjika, which she says is the Vogue series, women who are posing on the magazine covers, they don't realize that the images or actions and all things are taken from the the traditional, and it's still getting shown today in today's world, but very unconsciously. So she is talking about beauty and what is perfection. So that's how Vogue and Shalbhanjika goes all together. And as for yoga series, those are just simple, daily routine of, getting into in form of exercise where you don't have to really get into, sweating yourself out. But it's a state of mind. It's meditation for her. So that's what I can say about the work.
Besides that, I also find, one very, very kind of a refreshing thing within the works is the use of color. I love that. I love the fun within the work as well. Besides being a serious kind of a body of work, it has also got this element of fun and this element of a persona within the work.
I'm with Sachin right now at Exhibit 320, and Sachin is known to make paper look like something it's never looked like before. So Sachin, can you take us through a little bit through your works and what the comments
for
is?
History, her story, it's about to work upon certain feelings, personal. Like usually I was working on, I think, something which global around the things type. But I think even that also started off as because me being in the city, I viewed myself like that. Yeah. So the one paperwork which is there, it's like how the person, like whoever it is, like into the chaos and like surrounded with buildings and everything. But it doesn't matter. Like eventually, it's that beauty of chaos that he is living in. Mm-hmm. So it was just a trick to like how to get the beauty of the whole chaos factor.
Yeah, especially in this work which you have, with the shadows
with
falling
the shadow
on
thing.
It.
That's very like a new attempt to just figure out, because early morning and all, you go for a walk and you see the shadows, and I'm working from home and I keep seeing the shadows keeps changing and everything. Yeah, so I want to somehow capture that shadows, because maybe for that short term, the shadows are not permanent. Okay, so, and maybe for a long term, those buildings are also not permanent. So I was just wondering how exactly to capture it, with the morning sun, all the shadows just comes out to the lane, how to get that. So that's why the whole feeling of that rising sun kind of a thing, and slowly getting, and I think it's just the first step which I want to still work on something, but glad to make that change from the framed works into that shadowed thing.
I have one question. How did you decide to use paper as your medium? You know, most people have gone through their lives with paper, but never actually looked at it the way you look at it. So, you know, how did that kind of come about?
And what do you see right now is something like really evolved from maybe like small paper toys happening on the desktop. Mm-hmm. So from there, and like I was into paper engineering, like pop-up books.
Right.
Like so this movie, they teach you pop-up books. So like
right.
I started learning it myself, folding. Mm-hmm. And then once I learned the entire technique of pop-up, then I want to do like something not inside the page, so limited, something really big. So I kept on making like that.
Mm-hmm.
And so like that, it just went on like step by step, one thing leads to another.
Example, like, you know, in a lot of your works, when you look at it from far off, it's a very it's a kind of a happy, natural kind of a scene, pretty scene. But when you look closer, you actually get the social comment, or you know, the issue you're talking about. For example, urbanization and what it is doing to us. You know, in your series with those flowers, you know, the flower collages which rise out like, you know, a mammoth, this thing, where you are actually looking at the work and you're saying, oh wow, pretty flowers, but when you go near it, it's urbanization with these tall skyscrapers popping out from the flower petals. So I mean, you must have actually gone through a lot of evolution and coming to something like this.
It was just the whole thing of like finding again myself to the city, like, and many people, like maybe from far it looks like really good, okay, I go to that city, you know, things are going to work out fine, but once you're in there, then only you'll see. So how to get that kind of a thing, and like slowly you see like cities also growing up like in a very organic pattern here and there. So a lot of thoughts like overlapped and everything, and like together it came out like that. Like, so like this carnivorous plants kind of a thing, no? All the carnivorous plants, they look really good. But
yeah.
It's something trappy, I think. Some that kind of a feeling. So just getting it.
Thank you so much, Sachin.